on 11. Gets the call from the bullpen to pitch in relief.
Number 11.
So striding in, Tim LoCastro. As he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. And here's a called strike at the knees. Don't think he liked that one too much, but it's 0-1. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Waiting on it is Almora. He's got it, and there are two down now. Digging in now for the Yankees, Malik Smith. See if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out. Here in inning number six. No balls and a strike to count.
Good pitch right there from the reliever. Tough for hitters to do much with pitches in that location unless they're looking for it.
Behind 0-2 now.
Some guys have no trouble hitting with two strikes, and some guys never want to get there. Let's see.
Okay, got that one.
There is, this is strike three, and that will. And that'll bring up Gleyber Torres. Fourth trip to the plate for him.
Leading off of the
risk of ending that nice hitting streak that he's put together.
It's on his mind, Matt, but you just have to let that get out of the way as best you can. You have to approach this at bat just like any other. Otherwise, you're just getting in your own way.
0-1 count. Here's the pitch. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. Bouncer up the middle. Story plays it in, and he'll throw against his body to first. Close play at first, but a great stretch that time as they get him by a step for out number one. Here's big Aaron Judge. He's two for three and looking for more here.
Aaron Judge.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch.
1-0.
Fastball missing down and away for a ball. 1-0. Started to go around, but it's ruled strike one anyway. We're in the seventh inning now of a pitcher's duel. 2-1 our score. Bullet back up the middle.
Why are we shifted so far?
Into the outfield for a one-out hit. And this is going to find a wall out near the Yankees.
So weird.
And there's your tying run at second base for the one-out double. Finally, a little something for them to get excited about.
Yeah, a rally can begin with a single swing of the bat, and this might be their chance right here. They've struggled to produce a lot of runs, but there he is at second base. A shot to the outfield scores him. Then who knows what kind of roll they could get on. Got to take it one good at bat at a time.
A ball and a strike now. A 1-1 home. Swung on and missed, and that's strike two. One run, six hits. Behind the plate, and that'll go down as a very important out number two.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
One ball, no strikes to count.
Let's go now. One time.
Ball and a strike. Judge stands at second with two gone. In the dirt here. Runner holds as the count moves to 2-1. Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery.
D-Rod.
To 2-2 now.
Hey, now we've got two.
Hit down the third baseline. Scooped up on the backhand. And that is
okay.
What matters here in the seventh. So it's no runs on a hit, no errors, and a man left. Eighth inning coming up. The Braves lead it 2-1.
Your Sonny attention, Ray.
It's on to pitch now out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the
number
eighth.
28. Johnny.
That save number 33 on the season for him, matching my career best for a season. The difference is he still has a chance to notch number 34. Another nice outing from him.
Close one. Game. 2-1, the final score. The Atlanta Braves took the lead in the fourth.
Keep grinding.
From the bullpen to do the pitching. Sliding into the box, Miguel Andujar. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Fastball right down the middle for a strike.
up there. Let's go, kid.
This one's down to third. Camargo's got it. And that's out number one. Next for New York, Ken Rowell. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. For sure. Oh, what a stop on the fly. Not in time. Outstanding effort, but he can't get the out. So it'll be on the board with one gone.
So frustrating, D-Ro. You make a good pitch and you get these guys that can run around and they're fast. You think you have an out, and all of a sudden it turns into an infield single.
Yeah, this is definitely part of his game. The grounded back then. He's a speedster. He's going to get a ton of infield singles, and he knows how frustrating that is.
A swing, and this ball is blasted to right field. Nothing's going to keep this one in the ballpark. Into the second bag.
That wasn't at all where that ball was supposed to go.
He just can't do that. Goes to show there are no weaknesses in any of these games.
Stunts him out with a strike on the outer half. Behind 0-2 now. And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away. Stepping up to the plate, Gleyber Torres. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. And here's a ball out towards straightaway center field. Almora will reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning.
Damn.
Fair to say, oh my goodness, these folks are not headed for a career on Broadway. Back to Yankee Stadium after this. Ready now, Aaron Judge.
Leading off with a Yankee.
Not much out of the three hole in this one. Hitless in three at bats so far. Called a strike on the outer half, 0-1. Here's a fastball that crowds him a bit, and it's 1-1. Into the corner and slicing foul. The 1-2. Swung on and missed.
There goes Judge.
That's the third time in this game he's gone down on strikes. Not the game he was hoping to have when he was taking batting practice, but at least his guys were ahead.
Giancarlo
in there, no balls in the strike. Six runs, seven hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far. Chased a low ball there, and he's quickly down in the count 0-2.
Classic case right there of an off-speed pitch, and that hitter's eyes lit up, and that front shoulder went flying. He's got to find a way to keep that thing tough and play with the big part of the field.
Well, you know what? Good hitters are good hitters for a reason, D-Ro. To be able to hang in there on an 0-2 pitch and still be able to get a base hit, this guy's about as good as it gets.
Yeah, I'm blown away by this guy.
You wouldn't know if you showed up. You wouldn't know if it's 2-0, 3-1, 0-2. Counts do not matter. This guy trusts in his craft.
Behind 0-2 now. On its way, the 0-2 pitch. He goes with the slider that time, and it's driven to deep right field.
How?
And it's gone.
Fucking kidding me. Come on. There's a lane in the inside. Get the fuck out of here, man. I want my agent to call me. I don't want to play for the Braves anymore. I want to freaking trade.
No hits to this point. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1.
Son of a bitch. Come on. Get over the freaking plate. Shit, come. That wasn't at all where it's supposed to go. It's supposed to rise and go to the right. That slider is massively nowhere near where it's supposed to be. Bullshit. I'm just sick of coming into garbage time ass games. These games don't even matter. We were already down six runs.
You don't get too many pitchers today in the big league middle cut. His eyes lit up right there. This pitcher's lucky he's not getting another ball from the umpire.
Sure,
so I'm just not. Don't worry about any of these games. I'm just fucking playing just to play.
Leading off for the Yankees.
Ready, here's the first offering.
That last at bat when he went deep, he turned around a pretty good fastball, so of thinking this guy's a good fastball hitter, so I might want to move that ball up and down and in and out. And try not to throw it right down the middle of the plate.
And the inning begins with a quick out number one. In now is the Yankees DH, Ryan Poole. He's broke a couple of doubles in three trips.
Ryan Poole.
I just want to be a starting pitcher again.
Into this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan Dero, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage.
Yeah, you know, Dero, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
Now batting, number 25.
Hey, let it fly, let it fly.
In now, Gleyber Torres.
Makes turn,
hard the opposite way. And that is in there for a two-out base knock.
Yeah.
I mean, there's no secret right now. It's a fight at the bat rack. Everybody wants up at the plate right now. They're feeling frisky. They're all pulling the trigger early, and it's working.
The right fielder, number 99, Aaron Judge.
Into the box, Aaron Judge.
Hey!
He will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. Struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here.
Ball
a little
one.
Bit low that time, maybe outside as well. A runner on first with two away.
Wait for your pitch up there.
And D-ra. It's a ball and two strikes now to Aaron Judge.
Don't kid yourself. He's well aware that he has the hat trick right now. And after that,
swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Yanks leave one, but no matter. They lead it 8-2.
Well, baseball is a game of streaks and runs, so a four-game skid happens to even the best of teams. The key is they didn't panic or press. They just came out here, played their game, and put the losing streak behind them, like professionals are supposed to do. Well done.
8-2 is how this one ends today. The Yankees used a nice fifth inning to take the lead, and they never gave it back. Jordan Montgomery hangs win number 11 on his line. So that just about does it. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way on over to theshownation.com.
Our final line score this afternoon, first for the victorious Yankees. 8 runs on 11 hits. No errors. Less 4 men on base.
This manager is hoping to stoke the competitive
fire. I wonder why our
pitching
staff hasn't registered much K's. Our starters suck. Julio has a 4.7. Our other starting pitcher's not even here. Gorha and Sorka are both young guys that are A-rated, so they're, of course, going to do it.
Take over on the mound in relief.
Number 11.
Up next from Miami, Dwight Smith Jr.
Leading off for
two with a fly ball and a ground out on his line to this point.
Hey, get your pitch. Let's go.
I'm just not sure why I'm not starting.
Here it comes.
It doesn't rely on stats, it relies on ratings. So I'm puzzled at what ratings I don't have that are better than them.
Coming to the plate now, Evan Gattis. He was a ground out victim last time up.
Gattis
in there for strike one.
0-1.
Okay, knock it down, infield.
High in the air,
carrying. Are you serious? There was nowhere near him. Get the hell out of here. There was no... No. That was in a blue area. No, it wasn't. He fucking hung it like a... Of course he hung it. Well, I should go down to ratings this game, too.
He looked to bounce back after striking out last time up. Strike one to start the at bat. Late swing and a miss, strike two.
Man, when you're struggling at the plate, that pitcher smells blood in the water. He's coming right after you, trying to end it quick.
On to Freeman at first, and there are two away now. So here now is the pitcher, Harleen Garcia. He bats here with a three-run lead in inning number six.
Come on, catch the ball, catcher. They're being a pansy. Just catch the ball. There you go.
Well,
I can't catch the ball. It's too fast.
Popped up. DeMarco has a play. He makes the play, and that'll end the...
Charles
Gonzalez.
Doesn't matter, we weren't going to win that game anyway.
Miami Marlins jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Harleen Garcia wins his team-leading 10th game of the year.
I regressed a freaking overall.
Now pitching left takes the mound as he's been called upon to pitch. Joannis Michael is up off the bench as he'll be asked to get something started in the half of the seventh.
1-0. It's not even close. Come on.
Marlins have some action in the bullpen now as a right-hander is up and thrown.
Ball, that's
circle change here, but it's taken for ball two.
So wait, it will curve to the right and up if it's to the left, but if I put it to the left, it curves left and up. What? It's not the movement of the pitch.
Is a chance. Well, your leadoff man has certainly done his part. He's gotten on base. You have to start clawing back into this game right now if you're going to find a way.
Oh,
four seam has no movement. It's two seam that rises.
Standing in, Dwight Smith Jr. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. Behind on that one, now behind in the count, 0-1. 5-2 our score as we play inning number 7.
I should have realized that.
Freeman waits on it.
My.
Makes the play, and there are two gone now. Here's Xander Bogaerts now. And with men on base and two away, it feels like this at-bat will go a long way toward deciding this thing.
No doubt, Matt. A base hit here changes this game quite a bit. But if they can't score here, it looks pretty bleak for them heading into the last couple of innings.
Ball and a strike.
Get your pitch and drive it right here.
and he lays off for a ball. 2-1. Two runs, eight hits, and no errors in the game for the Marlins. 3-1 to the Marlins middle infielder.
Well, tying run on deck. He should get something really good to hit right here. Okay. In a 3-1 count, I'd be sitting on a fastball middle in.
Take a look. Find looped out towards right center field.
Find the ball.
Base hit. So now they'll have runners on the corners with two away.
Hey, nice job all around right there. He's able to get a head start, full count, two outs. You know he's going right there. Batter didn't come out of his zone, no. Drove a nice single into the outfield. Now we got runners on first and third.
Hey, two runners at the corners, two men out.
Hey, one time, right now.
And he misses low with it, 2-0.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be aggressive. He can pretty much count on a pitcher. He's trying to get back in the strike zone. And with two guys on base right here, it's time to grip it and rip it.
Santiago would be next. 3-1 the count now.
3-1 with two on, and this is where you got to be geared up for something to drive. I don't think you can just groove him one right here. You still have to try to make a competitive pitch.
Trying to stretch. One back up the middle.
All right, got lucky.
In time, and the Marlins can't cash in here.
Your attention, please.
Sign to pitch out.
And he just keeps on going and going. That's save number 35 for the season. And he's proven to be as reliable as anyone in the game.
5-2, the final today. The Atlanta Braves jumped out to an early lead. Ready, and he'll take the ball from the manager. Now at the plate, Dustin Peterson. He flew out in his last at first pitch coming, here it is.
Ball one, no strike.
And fastball to start things out here. Not close, it's a ball and no strike. There he goes. That's a strike, to throw down.
Ball one strike.
Well behind the play, that's an easy stolen base. In the sixth inning here in a 3-1 ball game.
Ball.
And this is low, ball two. 2-1. Line drive to center field.
There you go, make
and
the turn.
And that's in there, base hit.
Amor, come on, dive through that. Why are you playing so deep, too? You guys are screwing me out in the field. This is probably the worst defense in the damn league.
Good looking swing right there for the baseman.
Liner towards second. Right there is the second baseman, and that will retire the... So a run on two hits, no errors, and a man left. Freddie Freeman is up off the bench. 8-2 is how this one ends today. The Fish with their 50th team win.
Sorka can't even get past five innings.
A pitcher is encouraged to keep looking for improvement.
For sure, I'll work on pitches, even though you won't change me back to a starter. Coach is just an ass. Come on. Put me back to a starter. I'm better than three out of your five starters. I don't have this. I don't even have bronze, I don't think. Nope. I could have had possibly silver. But for some reason, my slider is all over the damn place. Yeah. My fastball was the only thing that was even mildly accurate.
Number 11 will take the ball now as the new pitcher.
Number 11.
Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point.
Come on here, another game, it doesn't matter.
A ball and a strike to Colorado's leadoff batter. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Soft liner to the right side. And that is through into right field for a single.
Hey, sometimes that's how a rally gets started right there. I know it's a soft liner, but leadoff man on usually poses problems.
Here comes the first pitch. Comes right after him with a fastball for a strike.
Put a good swing on it. Here we go.
Hit on the ground down the first baseline. But that'll get foul. It's 0-2 now. Here it comes on nothing and two. Behind this as this ball is looped over toward first. But this is speared by the first baseman. In now for Colorado, Charlie Blackmon. He singled his last time. Set and he hit.
Nope.
And that one stayed too low, apparently. LeMahieu leads off first with one away. Rocky center fielder looking at a 2-0 count now.
Well, 2-0 now, and this is where he makes his money. If he gets a pitch to Hackett, you can bet he's not going to hold back.
The 2-1 home. Driven nicely into the gap.
Even though the movement was supposed to be not in the middle of the plate.
LeMahieu is on his way home. Now it's cut off. A throw to the plate. But it won't be in.
What the hell? That slider is weird. It has no break on it, even though it should break across half the plate.
When he comes up, he's thinking RBI. What does he do? Double the drive and another run. This guy is a money run producer.
David Dahl comes on with one gone here.
The slider isn't down away either.
Behind 0-2 now. Here comes the nothing and two pin. And the changeup is way low that time.
I like that they went away with that pitch right there. They really tried to tie him up on that previous pitch, so he was probably what we call
just kind of weird too.
He didn't get a strike there, but I'm guessing he was looking for another ball in.
Two down now.
Stepping in, Jordan Patterson. Another RBI spot for him. He's already got three in the game. 0-1 the count. Ready with the 0-1. swung on and lifted down the left field line, but it'll get back into the crowd as he jumps ahead of him now.
Oh, that's out.
Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses one and two. Scoops it up. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Striding in for the Rockies, Ryan McMahon can lead things off as they look to perhaps build on an already sizable lead. No balls and a strike to count. The windup and the 0-1. Hit hard on the ground to second. Oh, he has some trouble with it. And he'll have no play as he reaches first base safely. At the plate, Sandy Leon. He flew out in his last at-bat. First offering on its way.
Ball one.
And a fastball just below the knees, ball one. McMahon aboard here at first with nobody out.
Ball,
that's a little low there. It's 2-0.
D-Rod.
Let's it fly 2-0, but this one's by him for the first strike. And he lays off the circle change here as he moves into the driver's seat, 3-1.
No reason to sit on anything other than hard stuff in a location you like and drive it right now.
Swing and a little blooper to center. In there, base hit.
Maybe that's it. I'm letting it go and it's just snapping around.
So digging in now, Christian Arroyo. One for two in the ball game thus far.
Way
balance hack that time. Good for the first strike.
0-1.
Not much to say about that swing other than it should have never happened.
Very weakly on the ground. The right side. Leaping right, effort,
he's
but
he's
it's
up.
Off his glove.
Oh boy, great job.
Next to hit will be the pitcher, Sean Newcomb. He hits here in a spot where he might be able to put this one out of reach.
D-Rod!
Down five, another run across here could very well put the nail in the coffin. Mentally, they might still feel like they've got a shot if they could get out of this jam.
One time, right now. Here we go.
On its way, the 0-2 pitch. Grounded down the third baseline. This will wind up foul. It's still 0-2. Swing and a miss on a huge first.
There we go.
He sets him down swinging with the bases loaded. So the batting order turns over now and set to go DJ LeMahieu. He scored after reaching on a single in his last time up. One ball, no strikes to count.
What?
2-0 is this one's taking low.
Putting himself in a pretty bad situation now on 2-0 and the base is loaded. He basically doesn't have much of an option but to challenge him right here.
The 2-1 home. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Step on the back for one.
Get out of the inning.
And they turn the double play to end the inning. So no run. Carlos Gonzalez.
Now pitching.
Hey, it's hard to win games at any point, but to win games on the road, especially in this ballpark, so they are very happy with this win.
This evening's ends at a...
Now pitching for the Braves.
It's the call from the bullpen to pitch in relief. Here's Charlie Blackman now.
Leading up for
first delivery to him on the way.
Yeah.
Takes a knee-high fastball.
You know, you look at this hitter, he doesn't care about being down 0-1. He doesn't care about having two strikes with him.
That's a
He's
ball.
Got the utmost great confidence in his ability to work back into the count and get him something over the heart of the plate.
1-1 pitch is a circle change. It hits the target, 1-2. This is on the ground over the first.
Nice.
Bag himself to the out. Now it'll be the four-hole hitter, David Dahl.
Now
he was retired via the ground ball last time up. Now here's a comebacker back to the mound. Flip this on to first for the second out of the inning. So coming to the plate, Jordan Patterson. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
All right, just kind of pushing here.
out, nobody on.
Little guessing game going on right now. Being late on that fastball after the change, he had to be sitting off speed.
One
right
and two.
Okay,
come on,
one
now,
ball and two strikes to count. The 1-2. Misses. Boom. Ball two.
After two breaking pitches, there's a pretty good right chance here. Right now, you're probably going to get something right in the middle of the strike zone to swing at. So if you're looking for it,
I wonder if there's a control issue or what.
Anytime you can win a game, let alone on the road, you have to feel really good about yourself. It's not easy going into that other team's ballpark and coming out with a win, but they did just that.
A 5-0 finish tonight. Colorado took the lead in the second inning and rode that until the very end. Herman Marquez picks up his team lead.
Actually, we're up in most stuff there.
Allowing only a pair of hits.